Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to the WKS Slask Wroclaw shooting range for the last final of our stay here, 10-meter air rifle woman. I'm Hillary Russell and have the pleasure once again to have USA's 2010 World Cup final bronze medalist Jamie Byerly here with us today. Welcome, Jamie, and thanks for joining us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to be here.
It is the last final. We've had, 4 days of just one final after another. It's been a real action-packed week, to say the least. And we do still have one more competition coming up, and that's the Champions Trophy.
Yes, it'll be interesting. It's always a fun match, and unfortunately, I can't shoot in it this year. But
it was 2009 that you won, is that right?
I won 2 years, actually.
2 years?
Yeah, last year and the previous year.
God. Yeah. And it's CUSA that hosts this, and it's a cash prize, is that right?
Yeah, 5,000 euros.
Nice. Yep. Very nice.
Yeah. It was a nice add to the income.
I'm sure. And so that will be taking place. I believe we start that off at 2 o'clock. Mm-hmm. I'm not quite sure. I can't remember if it's rifle or pistol that's going first. But
I think it's pistol. Yep.
And in just a couple of minutes, we're going to get this final started, the last one of the 2011 season. Jamie, you want to go over the event details of today's event?
Oh yeah, we're shooting the finals of 10-meter air rifle women. The distance is 10 meters. They're using a 4.5 millimeter or 0.177 caliber rifle, and the max weight on that is 5.5 kilograms. They're shooting a pellet, which is 4.5 millimeters. The bullseye is a half a millimeter big. They're shooting 10 shots in the final. Their match was 40 shots. And they get 75 seconds per shot on command.
And here are eight finalists today, and I'll have just a chance to introduce each and every one of them. I'm sorry to see that Katarina Emmons is not in the final today,
yes,
I have to say.
Me too.
In eighth place, coming in with 390 points, representing Poland, we have Agnieszka Nagy. She's 30 years old. She won the silver this year in Shangwang during the World Cup, and she also won the bronze in Munich in 2008 during the World Cup.
And the bronze medalist of the 2011 World Cup in Munich, Nagy Agnieszka.
Then in seventh place.
In the seventh place.
Coming in with 394 points, representing the Czech Republic, we have Adela
Sikorova, yeah, I think. Maybe.
She won the bronze medal in Munich in 2011 during the World Cup. In sixth place, coming with 395 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Xie Tingzhen, and she won the gold medal in 2010 during the World Cup in Munich. She also won the silver in 2009 during the World Cup in Shangwang, and also another one, a bronze medal in Milan in 2009. In fifth place, coming with 395 points, representing the United States of America, we have Sarah Scherer. She's 20 years old, and she won the gold medal this year in Shangwang. It's nice to see someone from the USA in.
Yes. She's been shooting quite well this year, so it's very nice to see.
Very nice girl, too.
Yes, she is.
Then in fourth place, coming with 395 points, representing Germany, we have Sonja Fielschifter. She's 40 years old. She's a two-time world champion and a one-time junior world champion. She is also a four-time World Cup final gold medalist and a 13-time World Cup gold medalist in this discipline. And we'll talk about her in just a little bit.
Yes, okay, we will.
Once again, not showing us her face. Third place, coming with 397 points, representing Italy, we have Petra Zublising. She's 22 years old. She won the silver medal during the World Cup in Milan in 2009, and she also won the bronze medal during the World Cup in Fort Benning this year.
2009 World Cup in Milan.
No, that would be Petra Zublising.
Yes.
We have her.
Our announcer has realized she announced the wrong person.
And here we go in second place, coming in. Second place, coming in 398 points. Representing Croatia, we have Snezana Pejic. She's 29 years old. She won the gold medal this year in the World Cup in Sydney, and she also won silver last year in Belgrade during the World Cup, and a bronze in Beijing in 2009 during the World Cup. And in first place, coming with 399 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Yi Sling. She's 22 years old. She is the current world champion and a two-time World Cup gold medalist, once being this year in Fort Benning, and the other one being last year in Fort Benning, and a two-time silver medalist during the World Cup, both times being in Beijing, once last year, once in 2009. So these are the finalists. Jamie, what do you think about the scores, and what do you see
happening? Well, you know, it's interesting because the men's air gun scores were all really high.
And, yeah.
399, 398 is a good score, but we have a lot of low scores as well. Mm-hmm. So it's just interesting. I thought today would be quite a competitive match, and it turned out to be not as competitive as I thought, yeah. And the top three have a pretty good chance of staying in the top three. They might move around together, but fourth is 2 points back. But mm-hmm. if anyone can make up 2 points, it's probably Sonia.
Right. Let's talk about Sonia for just a little bit here.
Yeah. We can see here she started out with 199, then she had 96 and another 100. She actually challenged her target. She shot two nines in a row, and she didn't think they were there, so she challenged it and moved points and mm-hmm. finished her match on a different point. In the middle of her third string, and she obviously lost the challenge and lost 2 extra points. So,
let me just go over the world record, and that was set by Korea's Sun Hwa Seo in 2002 during the World Cup in Sydney, and that was 400 points. The final world record was set by the People's Republic of China's Yi Sling in 2010 during the World Championships in Munich, and that was 505.6 points. So you really... You risk it to challenge.
You do. If you're incorrect in your challenge, you get a 2-point penalty. So you kind of have to be pretty sure. Of course, if you shoot a 6 or something, it doesn't matter.
Right.
You know, you might as well challenge the shot if you don't think it was there. But challenging a couple nines is a little risky.
Yeah.
Because, you know, we all shoot nines and we all make mistakes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just very hard for me to think that, you know, I should challenge a 9.
Right.
Chances are I shot it out there somehow. I might not see it exactly how I did it, mm-hmm. but chances are it's out there. And on the air gun targets, you can see a lot better. Here we have some Chinese writing.
That's right. Must be the Chinese coach. We do have two of our finalists are from the People's Republic of China, so I'm sure that they're just trying to keep score
yes.
here.
But on the air gun targets, you can pretty much see if your paper's moving.
Mm-hmm.
And if you shoot about 3 shots and they're all going in one hole, you'll see that. You'll see the paper, some white down there in the paper. It's pretty easy to see. Or, of course, you can get a scope out and look at it. And
right.
if it's moving, chances are the target is operating properly.
And there's no rules about taking out a scope and looking.
No.
Well, okay.
You can, yeah. And a lot of coaches you'll see with scopes,
mm-hmm.
you know, in the stands, especially for small bores since it's so far away and,
right.
You know, if the rubber's not moving or anything, I mean, it's easy to see, mm-hmm. very easy to see.
So why would you challenge instead of taking a scope and
you shouldn't.
You shouldn't.
Honestly, the easy, and you know, the hard thing with air rifle is you can't see the paper moves immediately after you shoot the shot, so you can't see if it was in the right spot because
okay.
it goes back behind the white, you know, of the target. Whereas in small bore, the target's so much bigger and it doesn't move as much. It moves really small amounts,
mm-hmm.
and so you can get your scope out. And you can see your last like 10 shots on the rubber, but air gun isn't like that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, once you shoot the shot, it advances and it disappears.
Okay.
So even if you do have a question that it wasn't there, you can't actually see it physically. You can only see if the paper is moving.
Okay. We've started off the match. We have Nage, who shot a 10.0. Now just waiting for Sai Kurova to shoot.
So I think we could have interesting movement in the bottom and maybe some movement in the top, but not sure if they're going to be moving with each other.
10.7 for field shifter. Nice way to start
that
out.
That will help her out a little bit.
Let's take a look at the standings now. We had Yi, who shot a 10.3, Paycheck a 9.8, Zublasing a 10.1, Field Shifter a 10.7, Sharer a
9.8,
Shia, a 10.3, Sykharova a 10.0, and also Nege a 10.0. Yi is still holding on to first place. She's got 1.5 points lead over Paycheck. And Zublasing is now 7/10 of a point behind Paycheck. Field Shifter is 1.4 of a point behind Zublasing. So you're right. You know, no, 1.4 of a point. Anything can happen. We're so early into this, I shouldn't even be talking.
It's so hard to decide what's going to happen in this. But if someone keeps shooting, if someone has some bad shots, definitely something can move around. So we'll just have to wait and see what happens.
It's a Z sling. No.
I think that is...
That is, yeah.
And of course, we're probably butchering their names because.
I'm quite sure it's Shia because I think that I asked them when we were in Sydney, I think, and got the right pronunciation.
You never know how to pronounce
some of the names.
A Chinese name. Looks nothing like it sounds.
Exactly. Not only Chinese names, but I'll tell you.
Yeah, there's a lot of...
Thailand? Forget about it. 20 letters and one vowel, and then you're on your own.
How do you pronounce something like that?
Shia and Sharer now.
And, of course, some people are shooting fast, and others are quite slow.
They really are. 10.7 for Sharer and a 10.3 for Shia. Of course, we'll be waiting for Field Shifter. She's always the last one to shoot.
She has a very long process, and she holds for quite a while. I'm not sure if she's looking through the sights this whole time, but she is definitely a slower, one of the slower ones.
9.8 for Field Shifter.
And you can always see her reaction. She shows everything.
She sure does. She's got everything on her sleeve.
Yeah.
You know, but I'll tell you, sometimes, even with good shots, she looks like she's really not happy with it at all.
Yes.
So let's take a look. We've got shot two. We have Yi, who shot a 10.5. Paycheck, 10.4. We have Zublasing with a 10.4. Field Shifter, 9.8. Sharer, a beautiful 10.7. Shia, 10.3. Sykharova, a 9.8. And Nage, a 10.4. Yi Sling still holding on to first place by 1.6 of a point over Paycheck. And Zublasing is still in third place. She's only 7/10 of a point now behind Paycheck. And Shia is almost 2 points now down from Zublasing. And Field Shifter is 1/10 of a point tied up with Sharer. And so what do you think? Things are beginning to move around a little bit.
Yeah, with 395 shot, I mean, we're going to see those three move around quite a bit, unless someone just takes over and shoots a really good one. But as we see, there's already been some nines shot here, so the men's final was quite interesting because I don't think they had very many nines until the last shot.
I know.
Everything went crazy.
Exactly. And that was a really exciting final to watch, you know, with a new final world record set.
Yeah, it's always exciting to see a new record set, by all means. So I don't think we'll see one today. The record is quite high.
Right.
Yi had it in at World Championships with a...
Yeah, she
incredible,
did.
Incredible,
505.6.
This is a very difficult one to break.
She's a tough one, I'll tell you.
Yeah, definitely.
She was one that was sick in Fort Benning.
I think she might have been. Yeah. One of the Chinese was
one
sick
of them,
in,
I think it was
in
her.
Fort Benning.
And she didn't give up, I'll tell you. She decided to wait to get any type of cure. 9.7 for a Zublasing.
Yeah, that can make things a little interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And Shia had a 10.7, so she gained a whole point on Zublasing that shot, so... Of course, we are watching foul shifter to shoot.
9.9.
And she's not going to be
She won't be happy. Nope, and she's not. Let's take a look here. We have Yi, who has shot a 10.7. And Paychik with a 10.6. Zubu Singh, a 9.7. Field Shifter, a 9.9. Sharer, a 10.3. Shia, a 10.7. Sykharova, a 9.9. And Nege, a 10.8. Yi is still holding on to first place, 1.7 tenths ahead of Paychik. Zubu Singh is holding on to third place, but Shia is putting the pressure on. She's 9 tenths of a point behind now, Zubu Singh. And Cher is moved up the scoreboard, overtaking Field Shifter. Cher is only a half a point behind Shia. We have only into we're only three shots into this final, so we'll have to see how the second part of it plays out.
And it's quite interesting because those two nines, foul shifter shot, were the same places, very similar places, her nines earlier today.
Really?
So maybe there's something a little bit going on with her position in there, and it's just a little uncontrollable, maybe. She doesn't seem like she's seeing these shots, so obviously. And so she has a little bit to figure out, maybe.
It's unusual to see her shooting
at
nines.
Yes, especially when she's behind, she tends to really put up a fight.
Yeah.
So we'll see. She's always a strong, of course, she's won 13 gold medals.
Exactly.
So obviously she's
in
strong.
In this discipline, I think she also won 13 in another discipline.
Yeah,
13.
She's obviously one of the top runners, and hopefully she can figure it out here.
Let's focus in now on Paychik and Yi.
Paychik is such a fast shooter. I don't know how you pull the trigger this fast, but she obviously is doing it well with a 398 today, and I only wish I could shoot a little faster.
On now to Zubu Singh, 10.5.
And that will help her stay in third place, regardless of what she shoots. But if she keeps shooting 10.7s, she will be moving up the scoreboard for
sure. In fact, she will be.
And Sonia found the 10
there we go.
With a 10.7.
That's more like Field Shifter's style of shooting.
Yes.
Let's take a look now. We have Yi, who shot a 10.2. Paychik, a 10.3. Zubu Singh, a 10.5. Field Shifter, a 10.7. Shearer, a 10.4. Shia, a 10.7. Sykharova, a 10.1. And a 10.0 for Nege. So things haven't changed around at all as far as the standings go for the first three. We have Yi in first, Paychik in second, behind by 1.6 tenth of a point. Zubu Singh is in third. She is now holding the third by 7 tenths of a point. We have Shia, who is climbing up the scoreboard, and Sharer now is in fifth place, and she's 8 tenths of a point behind Shia. Okay, so now things are getting
A little bit more interesting
and exciting. Yeah.
Yi is definitely growing her lead up there. And Shia is trying to find herself on the podium.
That's right.
She with a couple great shots in a row, and
it could happen.
It could.
Okay, there she is, Shia.
Attention. 3, 2, 1.
On to shot 5.
The Chinese are quite amazing. Normally you see a new one every match, and then they're in the final.
I know. You've got that right on.
It's
quite
amazing.
You see these shooter presentations that we have, and oftentimes I'll get one on a Chinese girl or man, and there's no photo even.
They've won nothing, no
photo, no information. We've got the age and their name, and that's it, and they win.
It's crazy. It's amazing. And the competition is so high in within their country that it's possible to have this. Winning in their country is high enough to win a World Cup.
I think so too. She has shooting another 10.7.
So Zubu Singh, 10.2. So we're cutting the lead quite a bit now.
Yeah, we are. This is after Yi shot a 10.4. We have Paycheck a 10.6, Zublasing a 10.2, Field Shifter a 10.8, we have Shearer a 10.2, Shia a 10.7, Sikorova a 9.8, and Nagay a 10.0. Yi still holding on to first place. She lost a couple tenths of a point there, but she still is 1.4 tenths of a point above Paycheck. And we have Zublasing, who is in third place right now, and Shia is only 2 tenths of a point behind Zublasing at the moment. Field Shifter has now moved back up the scoreboard. She's 8 tenths of a point behind Shia.
Yeah, it definitely helps. File Shifter shot 10.7 and the 10.8 back-to-back. These shots help you quite a bit, so, especially when others are shooting mid to low tens.
Mm-hmm.
Air gun, you know, tends to be a lot. You have to shoot tens, and a lot of them, and, you know, you have to shoot high tens to be competitive in the final.
Mm-hmm.
And she is trying to get back in there, so.
I'm sure that the nerve level for all these women must be extremely high. You know, coming into a competition as important as this one. But they seem to be handling it.
Yeah, well, you know, there's a lot of training that goes into that as well. And all of these women here know how to win, obviously. They've all won a medal.
Right.
That's how you get to World Cup final normally. And so they're a little more experienced than the typical, you know, shooter just shooting. So, but it is definitely nerve-wracking.
Sure.
Regardless.
Paycheck now on our screen.
We won't have to wait long for her, I don't think.
No. There we go. It's done.
Oh, she did not like that
7.
One. Yes. Maybe opening the door a little.
Zublasing, she's really got to nail this one.
And she's taking a second hold. She obviously did not like the first one. Staring it down still.
10.7.
Very good.
And now, of course, waiting for Field Shifter.
Yes.
And she shoots a 10.7.
She's still 2 tenths. Oh.
This is Yi with a 9.7.
Yes. We saw some couple nines there. Yi and Paycheck.
That's right. Both of them with 9.7. Zublasing shot a 10.7. Also, Field Shifter shot a 10.7. Shearer a 10.0. Shia a 10.6, Sikorova a 10.5, Altsa Nage a 10.5. Obviously, the scores between Yi and Paycheck haven't changed, with them both shooting a 9.7. Zublasing is now holding on to third place. She is 8 tenths of a point now behind Paycheck, and Shia is now 3 tenths of a point behind Zublasing.
Yes. File Shifter is 7 tenths behind
Shia,
so 1 point out of a medal, and with 4 shots left, and so
4 shots left, and things can change around.
Yes, people need to shoot well, but I think someone needs to shoot a couple poor shots. Fair.
Now, are you surprised to see the shots in the nines or not?
We always see a couple, but it's always interesting going into a final. You just never know what you're going to see. You know, one day it's everyone's shooting 104s and 105s, and the next day everyone shooting 102s.
Right.
And, you know, one or two people will be above that, of course, but sometimes you just, it's amazing. You just never know.
On now to shot 7 for Paycheck.
Normally we see air rifle finals very high, but
9.8.
Not going to be happy with that.
No.
It's a chance, I think, for some people to move around
so.
With a couple nines in a row. And
Zublasing.
She's taking her time, and hopefully it will be a good one.
10.1.
And I think this is a chance for maybe Sonia to move up a little. Shia had only a 10.2, so.
A 10.4 for field shifter. 10.2, for Shia as well. And let's take a look then now at the standings. As you can see, shot a 10.5. Paycheck with a 9.8. Zublasing a 10.1. Field shifter a 10.4. We have Shearer with a 10.2, also a 10.2 for Shia. Sikorova a 9.7, and Nege a 10.6. We have Yi still, she's gained some tenths of a point there with that 10.5. She's at 2.1 tenths of a point ahead of Pejcic now. Pejcic is still holding on to second place, but only by half a point over Zublasing. And Shia is now 2 tenths of a point behind Zublasing, and Field Shifter is on Shia's heels, only a half a point behind. They are making it exciting, I'll tell you that
they
much.
They are, yes. Field Shifter has 7 tenths to make up to see herself on the podium, and Shia only 2 tenths. So I didn't think it was going to be very likely. My prediction in the beginning was not very good, but 2 points in airgun tends to be quite a bit. It's you have to shoot a really good final to make up 2 points, and someone has to shoot kind of a low one. So I guess we'll see here in the next 3 shots. Someone can move around. It's always exciting.
And as
to see it moving for spectators.
That's right.
Sometimes you don't want to see that.
And now they all know where they're standing. The speaker has given them the information. It was either going to be used for them or against them.
Mm-hmm.
Yi now getting ready to take her 8th shot. Shoots a 10.4.
Yes, and she can maybe relax a little bit.
Yeah.
She's 2 points ahead, and then with 3 shots to go, that's quite a bit.
Let's see how this goes for her teammate, Shia. For Shia.
I think it will have to be a little deeper than that to move around a little bit.
Zublasing with a 10.5.
Now we will wait for Foul Shifter.
Yes. And Nege a 10.7.
Stop.
And let's take once again a look at the standings after shot 8. Miss, we have Yi, who shot a 10.4. Pejcic a 10.3. Zublasing a 10.5, Field Shifter a 10.4, Shearer also a 10.4, Shia a 10.3, Sikorova a 10.1, and Nege a 10.7. So we have Yi with 2.2 tenths of an advantage over Pejcic. Zublasing is in third, and she's only 3 tenths of a point now behind Pejcic. And Shia is 4 tenths of a point behind Zublasing. And Field Shifter is only 4 tenths of a point behind Shia at the moment. So it's really coming down to these last 2 shots to determine, really, at this point, silver and bronze, with only 3 tenths of a point between them.
Of course, if they keep it in the 10 ring, I think it'll be okay. If it's mid 10, but a 9 can definitely change everything around. Getting into the last couple shots, you start to feel a little more pressure. I think we were talking about this the last final we were commentating together. So,
well, your heartbeat probably gets a little bit faster. And
you know what's going on. You know where you are. You know, for Pejcic and Zublasing, they know they're not very far out of, people are chasing them up behind. People behind have nothing really to lose. They're in the chase, so they're really going after it. And the two that are in second and third feel like they have something to lose. So it's an interesting feeling all the time, but all you can do is take a good shot. And
hope it all works out for you.
Yes.
And that's a 9.9 for Pejcic.
That is possibly going to hurt her quite a bit.
Waiting now for Shia. 10.4.
Will not, I don't think it will move her up, but gets her a lot closer.
There's Zublitzing a 10.4. And now just waiting on field shifter. You know, after those two nines, she really has gotten back into her own groove.
She has.
You know, a 10.7.
Yes, and another 10.7. Yeah. So, you know, those nines are frustrating, but she has one of the high finals. And
things have changed. Jamie, we have Zublitzing has now overtaken Pejcic. This is after Yi shot a 10.5. Pejcic a 9.9. Zublitzing a 10.4. Field shifter a 10.7. Shearer a 10.5. Shia a 10.4, Sykharova a 9.6, and Nagai a 10.1. So we have Zublitzing, who is holding on to second place now, 0.2 of an advantage over Pejcic. And Shia, that was only 0.1 of a point behind Pejcic as well.
Yeah, I think Shia is 0.2.
I'm sorry, 0.2.
And Sonia is 0.1, so.
So it's going to be the last
shot.
This is good. This is really good.
Yes, this is always exciting for the spectators.
Probably for the shooters, not so exciting, but.
Yeah, no. I think I would much rather have a 5-point lead or something. as everyone would like a 5-point lead. But Shia and Foul Shifter both have a chance at a medal now. A deep 10 will...
And we all know Field Shifter can do that.
Yes, and Shia as well. They both have the two highest finals as of right now.
Mm-hmm.
Shia with a 94.2 and Foul Shifter with a 94.1. So it's going to be an interesting one.
Yes.
Of course, we'll have to wait a little while because we'll have to wait for Foul Shifter to shoot.
Of course, we're going to have to wait a good half hour to find out.
So.
No. Okay, let's take a look now at Shia. Yi.
And she is pretty secure. Good shot here is all she needs, or a decent shot.
Right, Yi.
Yes, yes. And a 10.5 is secure for the gold medal. And Pejcic had a 10.3, so we'll have to wait for... The others.
That's
see
right. Zublitzing now around. Getting ready.
Lots of nines on the bottom half of the final. Oh, and Shia had a 10.0, so that's not going to be enough.
Nope. Zublitzing a 10.0 as well. Yeah.
Opens the door for Sonia.
And a 10.8, of course.
She moves up into second place.
Unbelievable. So. We have, look at her, finally a big smile on her face.
Yes.
Sonia Field Shifter finishing off with a 10.8 and bouncing right up into second place. There she is, our silver medalist. Let's take a look if we can find our gold medalist. Yi Xing from the People's Republic of China wins the gold medal today. She's such a sweet face.
Yes,
she's really
they
cute.
Always do.
They do. Really great accomplishment for Yi Xing. And we have our silver medalist, Sonia Field Shifter from Germany. She just did an unbelievable job of climbing up the scoreboard in her last shot. And in a second, we'll take a look at our bronze medalist, if we can find her. And there she is, bronze medalist. Susanna Pejcic from Croatia, winning the bronze medal. Excellent work also by Susanna. Jamie, I want to say thanks again for joining us today, and I wish you all the luck in the future for the end of this year.
Oh, yes, thank
and
you.
And look forward to seeing you next year as well.
Yes, I will be there.
And also, congratulations to you and Hank on your wedding.
Oh, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Brak, 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 brak